Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Zach, and I'm finally here with a very highly requested video. Yes, this is What's on My Android Phone, early 2017. Of course, I do these throughout the year, but yes, this is the first one of 2017, so let's go ahead and get started. So as you can probably tell, I am using the Google Pixel XL as my daily driver. In my rant video that I did a few months ago on this phone, I did say that I would probably end up ending the year with my SIM card in this phone, and that is indeed the case. Pixel XL is my favorite Android phone, and in my opinion, it is the best Android phone out right now. As of the recording of this video, it is the best Android phone out right now. So I'm using it as my daily driver. And I'm also showing you the back here because I also am using the marble skin here from Dbrand. I'll toss a link for this down below in the description. I've been throwing marble on pretty much everything that I have. It just looks so sick. I love it. And it goes really well with the white Google Pixel XL. So, all right, so finally taking a look at my lock screen. Nothing too crazy going on here. I do have AZ screen recorder, and if all things go well, if everything works out, my screen will be right up here so you guys can get a nice idea of what my screen actually looks like, better representation of what's on my phone. So let's go ahead and unlock my phone using the fingerprint scanner on the back. So here is my home screen. Yes, this is what I've been using for the past couple minutes. Actually, I kind of just cooked this up right before this video, but it's very similar to what I've been using for the past few weeks. So, all right, so yes, I am still using Nova Launcher Prime. A lot of people have been telling me, why'd you try something new? Trust me, I have tried pretty much every other major launcher out there, and I keep coming back to Nova Launcher. It just gives me everything that I need as far as customization goes. I can make all the changes that I need to make. Some other launchers out there can't really provide what Nova Launcher gives me. So this is the Pixel Pill Widget Pro that I've got here. And I actually featured this in January's Best Android Apps video. It's a very, very accurate representation of the actual Pixel Pill Widget. And I mean, the one that comes with Nova Launcher is cool and all, and you can get some nice ones from Super Widget, but this one actually has the most accurate representation in my book, and it's definitely recommended. It is free. Most of the major things that I talk about, I will list down below in the description, so make sure you check that out. But I really do like this, not only because of its looks. I can actually customize it if I wanted to, but I can actually get quick access to my weather up here, which is really, really handy. So if I just wanted to get some quick info on what the weather's going to be like today, tomorrow, or for the next 10 days, then I can do that. There we go. So that's really cool. I do like that. And, you know, good looks all around. So taking a look at the bottom here, unlabeled icons. I also have hidden my status bar. So that's pretty cool. And yeah, you guys know how I like to say pretty cool a lot, but I am using the Delta icon pack, and I do have my most used applications right here. I have the YouTube Creator Studio down there, you know, just to keep up to date on my analytics, just to answer comments and all that good stuff. I have Google Inbox, Google Keep. I use that all the time just to, you know, keep myself organized and all that good stuff. Twitter, you guys know I'm on Twitter pretty often. Maybe I should post more, but I'm on Twitter every day. And then Spotify, that is where all of my music lies. I don't keep any music in the actual phone itself anymore. Those days are pretty much gone. All my music is in Spotify now. And then I have Google Messenger there, and I am trying to use Google Photos. I'm actually forcing myself to use Google Photos by putting it right there. It's really, really useful, but I'm trying to force myself to use it more because it is so useful. And then on these two sides, I do have two Zuper widgets. They have been pretty heavily edited. If you guys would like a tutorial on how I do that, it's actually not that complicated, but if you guys want a tutorial on how I do that, then leave a like on this video. But basically, I have, since my status bar has been hidden, I don't have access to what my battery percentage is, so I just made a little widget right there to tell me what my battery percentage is. And then I have Easy Tech right there just to keep it more personal. This is my setup here. So moving on to this screen here, we have month calendar widget. You already know month calendar widget pretty much has to be on every Android device that I have. It's got to be there. It's so useful. All the themes that you can get, you guys already know about that. Then I have power toggles. I haven't used this in such a long time. Power toggles, very, very useful widget. In order to get to all my quick settings, I gotta drag down from the top there. Yeah, it's really handy to have that here. So if I wanted to get to my flashlight, I can do that really nice and quickly. And then I can just, you know, do my brightness slider and other toggles. And of course I can add and take away different toggles and stuff, make the widget look the way I want it to. So that's pretty cool. And then over here I have, this is where I have my best Android apps of the month. Of course, I'm now working on February. Of course, there are no applications right there right now. But there will be applications there soon. This is the kind of area of applications that I'm testing out to see if they can make it into a video. You'll probably see some of these applications in upcoming videos, so stay tuned for that. But on this side over here, pretty much just basic stuff going on here. I do have my subscriber count up there. I'll toss that widget down below in the description as well. Then I have clutch points here. This is my main source of scores for the NBA. That's pretty much the only sport that I follow. Pretty cool stuff going on here. So that's what I use for my sports scores. Then I have Amazon. Of course, you guys already know about that. Instagram. I try to post every day, but I've kind of been slipping lately, but I'm gonna get back on that as soon as possible. YouTube to obviously watch videos. And of course I have Hangouts to keep in contact with people, and I have the Play Store there. Now taking a look at my app drawer, swipe up to get to my app drawer. I like to keep things nice and clean. I don't like having a long list of applications to scroll through. I like keeping everything in folders. So starting from the upper left hand here, I do have the Customs folder. I don't know why I call it Customs, it's kind of weird, but this is the folder where I have all of my icon packs, all my Zuper widgets, etc. And yeah, that's pretty much where all of these lie. In fact, I could probably hide these, but I do like to check out the wallpapers that some of the icon packs have, so I keep these on deck. And then over here I have my games folder. I don't really have a lot of time to play games. As you can see here, I've got a whole bunch of games, but I don't really have the time to play. But when I do have time to play games, I play Sidus, and you guys have actually seen this in a few of my review videos. Polyforge is also a fun game, as well as Z-Type, Hyper Burner, Jumpy Word, and then I have some emulators down there as well, to play actual video games. So I have a Google folder there, and then with all, of course, all of the Google applications that I use. And over here, I do have a photography folder with Retouch. I featured that in one of my best Android apps videos. Layout, of course, for Instagram, VSCOcam, and Snapseed, GiffyCam, JiffyCam, whichever way you want me to pronounce it, I will pronounce it. I like GiffyCam, Prisma, all the good photo editing stuff in there. Then I also have Shop. So if I wanted to shop for some stuff, shop for flights, Airbnb, Slick Deals, awesome stuff there. Game Time for sports tickets. I also have Foot Locker. I'm getting into shoes a lot now, so Foot Locker is really useful. Auto List for cars and stuff like that. Swappa for buying used mobile devices. And then of course flights with Southwest. So there's that. Okay, moving on to social, nothing too crazy going on here, just your general collection of social media applications. I am getting into Pinterest a little bit more often. Yes, in fact, I am. I have a sports folder, so I have Bleacher Report, The Score, Clutch Points. I'm still like battling between these two as to which one I really want to keep and which one I'll get rid of. Then of course I have NBA for League Pass, which is horrible. I really don't like League Pass. It's very, very, very bad, but I kind of keep it there just for that one moment that it'll actually work properly, and that hasn't been for a while. Taking a look at my tools folder. Yes, I've got a bunch of different tools here. So I've got a file manager. That one's probably one of the better, more minimalistic file managers that I've come across. I'll toss a link in the description for that one if I can actually find it. Send Anywhere is one of the most useful tools I've ever come across. I've actually featured that in a video before as well. Blur One to blur all my wallpapers. Parcel Track to obviously track my packages. A whole bunch of applications that I've talked about before. Of course, things like PayPal and Speed Test and all that good stuff. Dactyl, I've talked about this one in my previous best Android apps video, where I can actually use the fingerprint reader to take a picture, which is really, really useful. And Caffeinate, also talked about that, so make sure you check out my previous videos. You'll see a lot of these applications in those previous videos. So a bunch of tools in here, which is they're very, very useful. And then of course I've got my walls folder here. I will be doing a wallpaper video very soon, so stay tuned for that. I've got a whole bunch of wallpaper applications in here. Of course, you guys know I'm a customization freak, so it's very hard for me to keep one wallpaper set for more than a day. Then we've got the all-in-one calculator there. It's actually really, really useful. It does live up to its name. We've got all sorts of different things that you can do here. You have calculators that you can use for algebra, geometry, you've got unit conversion, you've got finance, you've got engineering, health. I mean, this thing, it just goes on and on and on. You can do pretty much everything in here. Very useful application. Definitely recommend that you guys check it out. Again, I'll have a link for this one in the description as well. But basically, that's what that application is. I've got a really nice Bible application there. I've got the camera. Candid, you guys already know about Candid. Check it out. Fitbit. Yes, I've been getting into the Fitbit. I do have a Fitbit over there, kind of just chilling. And then I've got Focus. If I'm not using Google Photos, then I'm using Focus. That is my go-to gallery application. Journey, I'm actually giving it a try. It's pretty much a mobile journal. You guys can laugh if you want, but it's actually kind of cool. I kind of like to look back and see what I was doing a few years previously. So yeah. Nudge.me, I also featured this in a previous video. This is a cool application to keep your mind working. So they come to you in the form of notifications, which is pretty cool. So something like this. I actually do not have the energy to figure this out right now. I'm just gonna go ahead and make a wild guess here. I don't Yeah, so, and if you get it wrong, you can check out why you got it wrong, and you can check out how to get it right the next time, so that's pretty cool. And yeah, this is really cool. You can do it for math and stuff like that. You can check out a bunch of different courses, so you have math and vocabulary and stuff like that. So that's pretty cool. It's a free application. Definitely recommend you check it out. I also featured that in a previous video. Of course, I've got Kodi and Netflix. You guys already know about Kodi. Got the dialer there, SoundCloud, Spotify, and Weather Timeline. That's pretty much it that's going on my phone right now. I do have a separate page here for Google applications. Of course, I have the folder there, but if I just wanted to check them all out, they're all right there, which is really nice and handy. I should probably make another one for tools because I've got just so many applications in that folder. But that's pretty much all that's on my phone right now, guys. So this is my setup. This is what's going on right now. Hope you guys, speaking of setups, I hope you guys are enjoying the Best Android Setup series. I really enjoy putting those videos together. So that pretty much does it for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, feel free to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, as I get another notification on my phone. But that does it for me, guys. I'll talk to you all in the next one. And thanks for watching.